This is Guardian Radio, your station for up-to-the-minute news, intelligent, interactive, and engaging conversation. 96.9 FM. The views and opinions of the hosts and guests are their own and do not necessarily reflect the position of the management and staff of Guardian Network.
With Juan McCartney is sponsored by Burger King, Commonwealth Bank, the Insurance Commission of the Bahamas, J.S. Johnson, Anyway Insurance Agents and Brokers, Ross Electric Motors, Struckon Pest Control, and Wendy's.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to the revolution. Welcome back. Welcome, in the first place, to the revolution here on Guardian Radio 96.9 FM. My name is Juan McCartney. It's Monday, October 31st, 2022. It's All Hallows Eve, right? Yeah, Halloween tonight. All right, you guys are going to go invoke demonic spirits and celebrate occult and pagan imagery. Go ahead, knock yourselves out. Go right ahead. We got enough problems in this country, but go ahead. Go ahead. Go dress up like witches and all this. All right. I was out last week for several days. I had to catch myself. I got the flu. And at first I felt fine. I was a little fluish and it started to pass, but then it kind of came roaring back. And I was just exhausted. Was really, really fatigued from the flu, and so I had to catch myself. So I caught myself, and here I am. I'm supposed to be off this week, but I'm going to do the show the majority of the days this week, God willing, so that we can catch up on some stuff. We missed a lot of stuff last week. There was that whole Bermuda thing, the BPL thing, for the love of God. And we need to talk about some things that are going on now. Okay, so here's the thing. I see that there's a lot being said about this Bermuda trip. And you know what? I'm okay with discussing the Bermuda trip. The Bermuda trip is something that speaks more so to however a couple hundred thousand dollars were spent, however many thousands of our dollars were spent. Less about the actual monetary impact to me than about the principalities of the matter. Right? Which is either we're going to have accountability or not. That's A. And B, I really don't want you spending my public dollars to go fund your political ambitions, whatever that may be, whether that's to foster greater ties between you and the PLP of Barbados because you love them so much, which is fine. I just don't want you to spend my money doing it. Now, I have a very large problem in theory, and this is going to make some of you angry, but I guess I don't care. I have a problem with the approach taken necessarily by the opposition. So first, let's be real. The opposition didn't unmask anything. The Guardian did, right? And you know how we did it? You know it's so stupid about all this? No, they didn't tell anyone the Prime Minister was going to Bermuda. So we didn't even know he's gone out of the country. And Travis was checking his Google alerts, and he just usually crawls for Bahamas every day, and he gets Bahamas back, and boom, the Prime Minister's speaking at the convention in Barbados. We had no idea, right? And we reported it. We asked questions about it. The FNM jumped on the bandwagon, and they were late and all sloppy with the messaging, because remember when you told me the plane is grounded? That's the important thing. Nobody's talking about the plane being grounded now, are they? No, the plane being grounded ain't the important part. And indeed, Western Air says the plane was never grounded. They just needed a SATCOM. Which I don't know why they didn't have one. The important part was, who's paying for this, man? All right, now if you're saying the executive's paying, I think we're owed an explanation as to why the executive is paying for PLP members to go to Barbados to a political convention. All right? I don't think we could characterize this as a campaign activity because you actually didn't go to, really campaign to get votes for the PLP in Barbados. It doesn't make any sense. But you did go to line up with your sister party in Barbados, which that's fine, right? I just don't want my money spent on it. So now the F&M's on message as of last week after we told them over and over. Because here's how bad they were. I don't mean to pile on y'all F&M, but y'all got to get it together, man. I'm sorry. It's not gonna work. The outside's looking in, and they're seeing this, and they're going, you guys are off your game. So you sent out a press release talking about the grounding of the airplane, which didn't happen. You didn't check on it. We did check Western Air. And then you reissue the press release talking about who paid XYZ. Now who paid comes to the fore. Now you're saying you're going to use the Public Accounts Committee to investigate the Bermuda trip. Why you want to waste our time and money doing all that, I really don't understand it. I could think of many other things that the Public Accounts Committee could be doing that could be useful. Investigating the Bermuda trip, I don't think is one of them. I think that leave that to the Auditor General, just like ain't nobody launched no independent investigation of the Barbados trip. Bermuda, sorry, I keep saying Barbados. Bermuda, my bad. Why is Barbados on my mind? Is Rihanna? Maybe Rihanna's always on my mind. Bermuda, sorry, my bad. Bermuda, not Barbados. I'm shaking it off. So it's Bermuda, PLP, right? So now I've lost track again. We can talk about Rihanna. No. So you're saying you're going to the Public Accounts Committee to investigate their Bermuda trip. No one really wants you to do that. We don't think it's a prudent use of our time, and we really don't think anything's going to happen from that. I wouldn't waste my time on that. There's a lot of time wasted in the Public Accounts Committee. Fortunately, and you're probably going to face this head on because the PLP is going to pull some shenanigans again if you get too frisky. Fortunately, Halsin Mutri found religion and restored the powers of the Public Accounts Committee during the last session of Parliament. And now you can actually go ahead and use the full power of the Public Accounts Committee. Use it for good, all right? For good, genuine, nice things. Do that, and we'll be good. We'll talk about something else that I thought didn't make any sense that I heard from the opposition last week. I'm not piling on opposition. It just is what it is. You guys don't have your game as tight as you need to. You got some stuff that's nice and going on, and I like where your head's at with BPL, because I was just astounded to watch that entire BPL thing unfold in the House the other day. And it gave me a sinking feeling of despair that the Minister of Works and the Prime Minister would get up in the House of Assembly and say they never knew anything about any request to move forward with hedging. The level of disconnectedness. I went to the sunken place. You saw Get Out, right? I was in the sunken place listening to that. It hurt me in my stomach that your Minister of Works is going to get up there and talk about he didn't know anything about it. It's such a negligent way to approach it because of what? Because they're throwing political jabs in the House? I'd never do that. I'm talking in front of my bosses. And I'm talking about the need for some major transformation with the organization. But I don't even know what's going on with the organization. I could get up at a press conference and tell you we're going to double your electricity rates, but no one ever said anything about a hedge to me. What? I was sad. Maybe it was the fatigue kicking in, but I was so sad hearing that. It made me sad for the country. Real talk. I'd rather him not say anything, both of them, about it, rather than be like, well, no one told me. How you mean no one told you? Ain't you paying Shell 90 minutes? They told you that. Anyway, today I want to send a shout out to Brenda McCartney out there in Tarpon Bay. It's her birthday today. Happy birthday. That's from her little brother, Kirk. Kirk McCartney. Shout out to the McCartneys in Eleuthera. I'm trying to hit y'all up this summer coming, Lord willing. I took the flight to Eleuthera. It's the first flight I took in a few years. It was only 20 minutes. A couple of whiskeys, although, you know, 7 in the morning, maybe not an ideal thing, makes it bearable. So I'm good. I'm down to go to Eleuthera. Farther than that, I don't maybe boat. But happy birthday, Brenda. That's from Kirk. Shout out to Kirk McCartney. All right, let's talk about Bermuda. Sorry, not Barbados. Bermuda. All right, and I'm just catching up from last week. Because while I think that the Prime Minister should not have paid for the PLP to go, I'm so lost as to what the F&M's talking about. And I'm sure I'm going to go get like calls after this and everything. But I have to address it. Because I think that this is a weak effort at scoring political points. And listen, you don't have to make necessarily sense when you're trying to score political points, but because all you really want when you're trying to score political points is you want a narrative to take hold. You ain't really got to make sense. If 2 + 2 don't have to be 4 in your political imagination. All you're trying to do is feed something for a narrative to take hold. Like when, to this day, right, if you say stop, cancel, and review with reference to the last Ingram administration, numerous members of the Ingram administration are going to say to you, that didn't happen. What am I hearing? Is that rain? Anyway, members of the administration are going to say to you, the former Ingram administration are going to say to you, that didn't happen. Let's examine it. Let's look at the logical conclusions of what was stopped, what was canceled, what was reviewed. And on if you look at it carefully, there wasn't really a whole bunch of stop, cancel, and review. Some projects were canceled, but governments do that all the time. And the PLP has done it over and repeatedly. But the PLP put out a narrative that took hold. Okay? Just like the F&M's putting out a narrative that you guys travel inordinately, that narrative is beginning to take hold. You notice most of your heat has come from trips, right? It's been a couple other things, but most of your heat has come from trips. The big heat. All right? So you don't got to make no sense, necessarily, if you're trying to put forward a political narrative. But I think it should uphold some scrutiny. So, and I watched House of Assembly, even in my deep sense of fatigue last Wednesday. And I saw the opposition. And let me say this. The speech that Pintard gave, the presentation he gave in the House of Assembly when he was talking about BPL, that may be the best presentation I've seen him give in opposition. I'll say that. By and large. But there's an issue with it, which I think is worth talking about. So, and Pintar has done this before, and I don't know why lawyers don't tell laymen if their points don't stand up to legal scrutiny. Okay, so Pintar has done this before, and they came and they answered him, which I wouldn't have done. So Pintar has done this before. So Pintar says, tell me which law allowed you to spend public funds to pay for people to travel to a political convention. I'm paraphrasing. All right? He says, tell me which law allowed you to do that, which is senseless, right, on the face of it. Yeah. So your suggestion is that there's no law that allows the executive of the country to spend public funds on political activity. All right? I'm going to say there is no law that bans them from doing that. I would like there to be a law. That would be nice. But there is no law, and you can't cite the law that specifically bans it. Now, he came back. So I'm going to go through it. So he says that the government, in his estimation, broke the law. Now tell me which law allowed you to do it, because I said you broke the law. Okay, so again, any lawyer can tell me if I'm wrong about this. So that's the opposite of how the legal system works. So the police can't come here and see me with this Apple Watch on and go, prove to me you didn't steal that. All right? You could try that. I think there's some old antiquated colonial laws that allow people to question how people have money and stuff like that. Prove to me you didn't steal this watch. That's not how the law works. If you're accusing me of breaking the law, it is on you to cite which law I broke. And so Clint's response was, I thought, perfect. Now, I wouldn't have kept talking, Clint, in some hot water with the women's groups. But I'm with Clint on this one. You tell me which law I broke. You're saying I broke the law, and I need to explain to you what law allowed me to spend money as the executive of the country? I need a specific law for political parties? I'm sorry. Do I need a law to specifically allow me to give crown land to Olympic medalist? Do I need a law to go ahead and fund the Bahamas Bodybuilding Federation when they're traveling abroad? Do I need a law to tell me that I can pay bail and legal fees for American lawyers for straw vendors who get caught with counterfeit goods in New York and to bring them home? I need a law to tell me I can. The executive has the power of discretionary spending. You know that. You were in the executive. I don't understand what you guys are talking about. I think it's such a weak legal argument to start off with. Tell me which law you didn't break. Tell me which law you did. What are you talking about? The executive makes decisions about spending every single day that is not authorized specifically for those purposes by the parliament. Every day. So if the Davis administration is breaking the law because there's not specific provisions to spend on political people going traveling to a political party, then every government has broken the law. Every single one. So don't give me that. All right? It's a silly game to play to say, tell me which law allowed you to spend money as the executive. Tell me which law allowed you to pay for a plane that the prime minister was traveling on. What are we talking about? I've traveled with the prime minister, okay, on Guardian business. There's no reimbursement. I didn't keep a journal. I got a per diem from the Guardian. They fed me. They housed me. They gave me transportation. They gave me a ride on an airplane. Was that illegal? Did they not have discretion to do that under the law? You can't point me to a single law that says you can't pay for people to travel with the prime minister, no matter what the reason. So it's a senseless thing to really put up as your grand gotcha. Tell me which law. It doesn't make any sense. Further to that, again, if you're accusing me of breaking the law, you need to cite which law I broke. Now, let's see what Pintard says. All right, because I don't know that this makes any more sense. All right, it's just a weak position, Pintard, is my advice, of attack when you're talking about the executive spending money, right? You tell me what law allowed the government to spend $600,000 furnishing the residents of Brussels. You see what I'm saying? Did he go to Parliament, and is there a line item for that, particularly that says Brussels? No. If there's travel, they don't get into the specifics of who all going with the PM and who can come and not come and da-da-da-da-da-da. Tell me what law allows them to take 70 people to COP27. Also, why are you taking 70 people to COP27? To do what? What's going to happen? For fun? Say that. Is it for fun so the kids can get a taste of Egypt? Where are they going? Cairo? Where's COP27? Anyway. So it doesn't make any sense to me, and we're dumbing down the discourse, right? Now, if you're saying to me, we should have a law that says you can't spend on political travel, okay. Fair enough. Or you could say, we should have a law that allows equal spending on political travel. Because right now, I'm sorry, not right now, during campaign season, you're still using government resources to take care of the prime minister when he is traveling throughout the islands. And the prime minister uses government, often uses government-funded initiatives, and government pays for travel for him to go do things that are used for express political purposes. So when Minnis went to open the Exuma Airport, which apparently they didn't have the money to fund, right? They didn't have any money to build it. When Minnis went to open the Exuma Airport and had Jenny Isaacs Dotson there, she was the candidate for the Free National Movement for Exuma. She wasn't any government official. She went there, was invited to the opening of the airport, traveled there with the prime minister from what I could see. Nobody said, what's the law that allows you to do that? Because he has discretion to do that. Now, if we don't like it, we can make some laws. We can propose some laws, which is fine. So let's examine what Pintard said. Because Pintard didn't cite the law. Then he comes back and says, well, it's shameful. You're pretending you don't know what law. You can't do that to me. I don't know. It's what law I broke. I'm so sorry. Tell me what law I broke. You say I broke the law? You say I defamed somebody? Tell me how I defamed them. No, you tell me how you did not defame them. No, it don't work like that. That's the antithesis of how the legal system works. He who accuses must prove. Otherwise, I'm innocent until you prove otherwise. Until you prove I didn't follow the law, I follow the law. That's on you, not for me to go dig through. How could I do it? Because guess what? Ain't nothing going to go through the public treasury if you're violating the law like that. That's to suggest that every organ of government is in on some sort of conspiracy, because the prime minister could jump up and down all day. If you don't have the legal authority to do something, the treasurer ain't going to do it. So let's see what he says. Okay, so he says that the government spokesman would do well to acquaint himself with Articles 130 and 131 of the Constitution. All right, okay, let's go look at it. I'm acquainted with the Constitution. Let's reacquaint ourselves with the Constitution. He says, Article 131 expressly says, public funds issued shall be disposed of for meeting public expenditure under Article 130 of the Constitution, or in the case of statutory expenditure, for the purposes appointed by law. What are you talking about? How did they violate the law by doing that? Is there not a travel budget? Yeah, again, this is weak stuff, Pintard. Let me see here. Article 130. You know how much times the government has spent our money on stuff that ain't specifically itemized in Parliament, and then rearrange it, then come back and reappropriate the money? Article 130 of the Constitution. I don't understand how that violates that. I'll be honest with you. Hold on, I'm getting to it. We got to take a break in a minute. Hold on, I know. We're supposed to have New Life come in the second hour. I'm not sure if they're doing the whole second hour, but we'll see. I'll have to find out. So let's go to Article 130 of the Constitution. Article 130. The Minister of Finance shall, in respect of each financial year, the earliest convenient moment before the commencement of that financial year, introduce an assembly and appropriations bill. Okay, fine. Subject to paragraphs 4 and 6, some set out an appropriation act in respect to financial year should represent the limit and extent of public expenditure. Okay. 3, when any sum is set out in the appropriation act in respect to financial year and at the end of that year there's an unexpected balance of that sum, the unexpected balance shall lapse. Minister of Finance may, in case of necessity, from time to time, cause to be prepared supplementary estimates of expenditure which shall be laid before and voted on by the House of Assembly in respect of all supplementary expenditure voted on by the House of Assembly. The Minister of Finance may, at any time before the end of the financial year, introduce into the House of Assembly a supplementary appropriations bill under the appropriate heads, the aggregate sum so voted and shall, as soon as possible, after the end of the financial year, introduce into the House of Assembly a final appropriation bill containing any such sums which have not yet been included in the appropriate... Okay, so it's not nowhere in there. That part of any estimate of expenditure laid before the House of Assembly which shows statutory expenditure shall not be voted on by the House, and such expenditure shall, without further authority of Parliament, be paid out of the Consolidated Fund. For the purposes of this article and Article 129, financial year, statutory expenditure means expenditure charge on the Consolidated Fund or on the general revenues and assents of the Bahamas by any provisions of this Constitution or any other law for the time being in force of the Bahamas. So I'm so confused. Show me where Article 130 has been violated. by that. Article 131. No sum shall be paid out of the consolidated fund except upon the authority of a warrant under the hand of the Minister of Finance, under the hand of some person authorized by him in writing. And some so issued shall be disposed of for meeting public expenditure authorized under Article 130 of this Constitution, or in the case of statutory expenditure for the purposes appointed by law. No, this is not that. So they're not in violation of the Constitution. That doesn't make any sense. So there's that. What else does he say here? Let me see. Don't get mad at me. I didn't say they broke the law. You know, you never heard me say that. I'm saying that I don't like that y'all are spending my money on political trips. Section 30 of the Public Finance Management Act. Okay, Public Finance Management Act 2021, Section 30, he claims that they are in violation of. Section 30 is commitments, authorization of expenditure. 28. Let's see here. Articles 128 to 136 of the Constitution shall apply in respect of the authorization of expenditure, control of expenditure. The issue of public monies from bank accounts of the Consolidated Fund shall be authorized by a warrant under the hand of the Minister or the Financial Secretary, authorized in writing by the Minister. Help me. How are they in violation? This allows the Minister of Finance to authorize the spending of money. Any financial warrants made, endorsed, or approved under this act may be made, approved, or endorsed by electronic means. The Minister... And this is 30. No public officer or public office holder shall commit the government to a financial liability, including a contingent liability, unless specifically authorized to do so under this act or any other act. Which one did he say they violated? 30. Which part of 30? 30, Section 1. And he said Section 11, 1. Okay, so 30, Section 1. No public officer or public office holder shall commit the government to a financial liability, including a contingent liability, unless specifically authorized to do so under this or any other act. Okay. Let's look at 111. I don't know how that violates it. This is, see, you gotta talk turkey now. I mean, you come telling me I break in the law. You're accusing me of doing something illegal. Now, if the prime minister say, you know what, felt political, we shouldn't be using public funds for this. Because that is the ethical standard, the moral standard, even if it's not a legal standard, then you should get our money back. And also, I want all my money back. And I'd like to know how much, like, the food was. I'm being petty with it. I want to know how much the car was. I want to know how much the taxi drive was from the airport. All this. For you to go to the PLP convention. Financial misconduct. So he's accusing them of financial misconduct. See how deep this is? Section 111.1. He says... This says, financial misconduct. A public officer or other person with responsibility for public resources commits an offense of financial misconduct if, without lawful authority, that person willfully or recklessly incurs expenditures or makes commitments for expenditure of public money. So you have to say willfully and recklessly incurs expenditures without lawful authority. Well, there's the thing, without lawful authority. And in what country... Call the Bahamas. Can the cabinet, does the cabinet not have the legal authority to spend money? How does that make any sense? The Minister of Finance, who's the Prime Minister, he doesn't have the authority to spend the money? So you got to come with solid arguments, man. I'm trying to see where this could end. Yeah, I don't see it. You gotta have a tough road to climb. You trying to get me to say I did something illegal. All right? The executive spends money. The executive, which is also the minister, right? And you have limits on that spending, but you have the ability to spend money. Anyway, let's take a break. We'll be back.
Tickets are selling fast.
It's a season of love concerts.
Performing live.
Darius Harris.
Wayne Wonder.
And The Hill.
Saturday, December 3rd.
Inside the Thomas Robinson National Stadium.
Nassau, Bahamas.
Tickets are available now.
At all your Cash and Go locations.
Or log on to cashandgobahamas.com.
Select the menu option.
And then select services.
And press tickets to be part of the biggest event of the year.
Or purchase your tickets by downloading the Cash and Go app.
Or visit your local Cash and Go store
by selecting the locator option,
where you'll find a physical location near you.
It's the season of love concerts,
presented by
Excalibur Entertainment,
YBE Promotions,
and All Star Productions.
Sponsored by
Bahamas Air,
Chef Creole,
Masqueraders,
Cash and Gold.
Family Island discounted flights are available on Bahamas Air.
Saturday, December 3rd, inside the Thomas Robinson National Stadium,
Nassau.
Gates open at 8 p.m.
Be there.
You do coffee your way.
Double shot, decaf, cappuccino.
Light roast, Colombian, no milk.
You do vacations your way.
Hiking boots, tent, mountains.
Five-star hotels and theater.
And now you can do insurance your way.
Online.
Email.
Chat.
WhatsApp.
Or in branch. For home, car, travel, boat, or business insurance, do it anyway with NUA Insurance agents and brokers. Visit NUAinsurance.com, call, or stop by a branch today.
Fidelity, we're good for you.
We know how important collecting your money can be to the success of your business. Start your relationship with Fidelity today so that we can show you the many options available to you with our merchant services. From click and pay options online to merchant terminals and e-commerce options, we're here to help your business succeed. For more details, speak to one of our business development officers at 356-7764 in Nassau or 352-6676 in Freeport. Visit our website at fidelitygroup.com or visit any of our branches.
Fidelity, we're good for you.
Buying a home is one of the most important investment decisions you'll ever make, so it's best to insure your home for the full replacement value. If your home is underinsured, the condition of average could apply and reduce the amount you'll receive if you make a claim. Ask your insurance agent about underinsurance and condition of average before you purchase or renew your home insurance policy. For more information, visit www.icb.gov.bs. This message was brought to you by the Insurance Commission of the Bahamas.
This is Guardian Radio 96.9 FM. Fresh news, smart talk, quality.
Breakfast just got better at Wendy's. Introducing the Breakfast Biggie Bag. Enjoy a double sausage muffin with two square sausage patties, a freshly cracked egg, and cheese served on a toasted English muffin, a medium waffle fries, and an orange juice for only $5.25, fat inclusive. Add an apple pie for just $1 more.
Say what?
At Wendy's, better breakfast is all day. Offers valid in participating locations. Wendy's, different inside and out.
J.S. Johnson Insurance agents are the best. Reliable service, we've been on the scene, protecting since 1919. J.S. Johnson Insurance has the best. Always, you'll always cover me. J.S. Johnson Insurance, peace of mind.
Tired of banks forcing you to use technology to bank the way they want you to? Your convenience is important. So no matter what your banking needs, Commonwealth Bank's friendly staff are always available in branch for that personal one-on-one service. But when you choose technology, our online and mobile banking app offers you state-of-the-art functionality. The choice is yours. Commonwealth Bank. Bank the way you want.
If you were exposed to COVID-19,
have symptoms, or traveled recently, get tested so that you can have peace of mind about your status. Just visit one of our convenient locations on New Providence at the University of the Bahamas or Golden Gates Plaza, weekdays 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. and Saturdays 10 a.m. to 6 p.m. On Eleuthera at the Three Island Dock, Mondays through Thursdays 8 a.m. to 6 p.m., Fridays and Saturdays 8 a.m. to 7 p.m., and Sundays 8 a.m. to 3 p.m. On Exuma at the Regatta Park, weekdays 9 a.m. to 3 p.m., Saturdays 9 a.m. to 5 p.m., and Sundays 1 p.m. to 6 p.m. On Abaco at Maxwell Food Store, Mondays through Saturdays 8 a.m. to 5 p.m. The COVID-19 test results will be ready in 15 minutes, and the tests are free.
This message is brought to you by PAHO WHO and the Ministry of Health and Wellness.
Good afternoon, Bahamas. Welcome back to The Revolution here on Guardian Radio. 96.9 FM. My name is Juan McCartney. Good to have you with us. Okay. We're just catching up from last week, really. So we're talking about the Bermuda trip. Not Barbados, Bermuda. And I appreciate the opposition's fervor, but you got to make it make sense for me. You can't. Oh, government broke the law. What do you mean? The Minister of Finance broke the law? Like, how? How did they break the law? How did they violate the Constitution? I'm so confused. Like, because what you say doesn't add up. Like, and you know what it is? And here's where you get trapped, right? And this is their last. And these guys have been in politics a long time. So here's where you get trapped. You think you're saying something that makes sense, and then the person you're accusing of breaking the law goes, well, since you say I'm breaking the law, tell me what law I broke, since you're so convinced I broke the law. You gonna haul out the Constitution? You're saying I violated the Constitution? Really? By having the PLP reimburse me for the flight they took that I paid for up front? I'm the Prime Minister. The cabinet says we're gonna pay for these 70 people to go to COP27. The Prime Minister says, look, you guys went to COP27 and advanced your own personal business interests. Y'all need to pay us back for the travel expenses that we undertook. And so a private company pays the Treasury back for some expense the government incurred initially. Like, how is that illegal? And so you're saying the Treasurer broke the law, too, by accepting the money? What are we suggesting? And so that's the problem. When you get into these, when you make these heavy allegations, you got to be able to talk Turk. You can't come, well, the Constitution and the spirit of it, I think the spirit of it is that you shouldn't be spending this money on political stuff. But we're talking about the letter of the law. You're saying I broke the law. You come with these heavy charges. You're saying I broke the Public Financial Management Act. I don't see how they violated the Public Financial Management Act at all. Section 111 or 30. I don't understand what that means. Like, so now you're called out here and you can't back it up. It says that's classic COVID one. Okay, then it comes back. You're patient zero for the next trip. COVID was a nothing compared to the I didn't feel fatigue when I had COVID. I didn't feel like great, like doing a marathon, but I felt a deep sense of fatigue, like, you know. After most of the symptoms were gone. Since COP27 is in Swarm El Sheikh, a luxury resort town in the Nile Delta. Nice. The irony of all these nations converging on this pristine piece of the planet by planes to hold a major environmental forum couldn't be more glaring. You got a point. So I guess the Seychelles or Maldives were unavailable. Says Juan, people today seem to be mixed up when it comes to who the onus is on to prove, disprove an accusation. They will accuse people of fraud, etc., without proof. People need to start suing for slander and libel to stop the foolishness. Of course, Pinter is protected since he made the claim in the House. Yeah, absolutely, he's protected. Does Dwayne Sands is a happy man? He's watching Pintard go down in flames. I mean, I wouldn't say go down in flames, but I would advise him, if I were close to him, stop doing this thing where you accuse people of breaking the law when you can't cite which law was broken. The penchant to say, show me what law allows you to do that, is a completely illogical legal argument. What law allows the Minister of Finance to authorize the expenditure of funds for travel when y'all made such a big deal about the increase in the travel budget? When y'all approved the budget, from what I could see, now it's what law allows you to spend the money? The executive spends the money. Parliament approves the spending of the money. The executive has discretion to spend that money. And I just read for you the Constitution. If I want to go take $50 million from the Defense Force without going back to Parliament and spend it on something else, I can do that. I just need to come back to Parliament and file new appropriation and table supplementary appropriations. All right, I could do that. Like Lang talked about the... Remember we were talking about BPL and Lang said that he had to take the... I don't want to get the story wrong. He said he was out of town and BEC said they have no money for fuel, right? And Lang called Ingram and Ingram was like, do what you got to do. And Lang took the money from BTC, the dividend, and paid the BPL fuel with it. Because the Constitution, the Public Financial Management Act, the Financial Administration and Audit Act, all right, gives discretion because they know that things arise that are out of the ordinary. And they allow you to come back to Parliament to do it. They also give you a contingency spending fund where you can spend over 5% over the limit that's been authorized by Parliament, and then you can come back. 5% doesn't sound like a lot, but we're talking 5% of $3 billion, and that it adds up. So to me, it's really not a germane argument to say, show me what law allowed you to spend this money on travel. Ain't no names in the budget, right? Ain't no, well, he could travel and he cannot travel and he can't. It doesn't work like that. Now, do I want you spending my money flying the PLP all over the place? Absolutely not. Do I think there should be a law to prevent that? Absolutely, I do. Because here's what I know about governments. When they see a government before them got away with a certain thing, the next government is likely to go, well, they did it. We could do it too. What law allowed... Minutes to go cheese up with Joel Osteen in Dallas. Remember he went to one thing in Texas that nothing ever happened with it to talk about Tech Hub or whatever that was. Then he went to go see Joel Osteen because why not? Let Joel Osteen pray over you. Did he? I think he did. I think he prayed over Minutes. Imagine if he didn't. Imagine where we would have been. What law allowed Christie? Remember Christie went to London? Christie took a jet, man. Back with people, right? Remember he said he was going to account for the price of the trip and everything? Went to London, then went to the Vatican so everyone could meet the Pope, which I get it. You want to meet the Pope. Back to London. Instead of coming home, went, we're going to go see Sir Sidney out there in California, Jetna. And they came back. And I was like, what's the problem? All right, we got to go to a break. I'll be right back.
Guardian Radio, 96.9 FM, Nassau, Bahamas. This is Guardian Radio, 96.9 FM. Fresh news, smart talk, all day.
Good afternoon, Bahamas. Welcome back to the Revolution here on Guardian Radio, 96.9 FM. My name's Juan McCartney. Good to have you with us. Okay. So the Office of the Prime Minister reached out to me during our break just now, and they clarified that the government is not taking 70 people to COP27, and the government's not paying for 70 people to go to COP27. Now, perhaps the confusion arises from Rochelle Newbold saying that there's a 70-person delegation. The director of communications said that the majority of the 70 people would be NGOs and civil society who are covering their own expenses. The government's covering the cost of its technocrats who will be in bilateral reporting on the country's progress on different events, and they'll be in negotiations, which actually something did stand out to me that Rochelle Newbold said. This is also from the prime minister. This says, the Prime Minister and his wife and the Agricultural Minister will travel Friday with a team of 8. The AG will travel when they return for the week of negotiations. Other government, technical, civil servants will travel over a 3-week period at different times based on their area and expertise from various government departments. All right. That's 19 people. The remainder of 37 plus people are all private sector and self-funded, from NGOs to youth organizations to private companies. Okay, excellent. PM, wife, agriculture minister, team of 8. Okay. AG, 19 other government officials over a 3-week period. You know what? I'm fine with that. That's good. That's good. I'm glad. See? Good. And the private sector and NGO people are going to pay for their own way. I think that's fine. That's fair. That's great. Great news. Who's paying for the youth? The kids. Anyway, good stuff. So, have fun in Egypt. What is it? Sharm el-Sheikh? All right, good. Good to know. So, 70 people not going to COP27 on the government dime. 70 people are going from the Bahamas itself. something stood out to me, and we're going to talk to New Life in a minute. Something stood out to me here that I saw Rochelle Newbull say about COP27. And I'll say this, because I like what Alfred Scherz was saying about Japan. Because I heard him the other day talking about ocean thermal wave energy. And I was like, what is this? What is Alfred Scherz talking about? We don't have any of that. But he went to Japan, where they do have it, and there's some technology they may be able to assist us with. Okay, so Rochelle Newbull, this is Jasper Ward's story on COP27. Rochelle Newbull, special advisor on climate change in the OPM, said Davis will be at the conference until November 12th. She said, there's a whole day, we're talking about finance, and you know, I want you to go get the carbon credits, PM. Let's do it. Get the debt forgiveness, too. He'll be meeting with partners in terms of having bilateral meetings so we can talk to our colleagues, such as Japan, where they have renewable energy technology that we were just there to investigate, and we're very anxious about getting here in the Bahamas, where we can replicate that in 9 different islands all at once. Well, glory hallelujah. That should be in the headline. Ocean thermal energy. I'm with it. Let's do it. Replicate ocean thermal energy in 9 different islands at once. You could do Eleuthera for certain. Because that, what is it? Western side of the glass window bridge? That's heavy. I don't know what new bridge y'all can build out there. That bridge, something, anyway. It's beautiful. Okay, so government not taking 70 people. And that works. We'll make sure to report that in the press. Says you're adversely impacting local politics by reducing the margin for cheap political points. I think he knows better, but it may have been worth a shot. Oh, you mean with Pintard? Yeah, I mean, you got to come with it. You can come style me like, oh, tell me which law he didn't excuse you. I'm sorry, what? I broke the law? No problem. Which law I broke? Sure thing. I'm with you. Tell me which law I broke, since you know better than me. You didn't adhere to the Constitution. What? The Public Finance Management Act says there's got to be a statutory. There is. It's travel. It's travel. You guys approved it. You asked me questions about it. We approved it. So then, Juan, I'm glad you're feeling better. Juan, if New Life comes on, can you ask him the eye wash, how often to use, and if it has to be in the fridge? What are the benefits for your eyes? Yeah, he's got some good stuff going on. All right. It's a good day. What were the benefits from COP26? I don't know, man. Maybe Rochelle Newbull could tell you. I don't know. You know what I want to have Chef back on one day. You know what I'm talking about that I'm very distraught over? But actually, Jamal Monker's coming, so I shouldn't disclose my bad eating habits so publicly. Do you notice it's hard to get, like, good Bahamian food? Like, good professionally done. But is it just me? I don't really fool with Arawaki for reasons I won't get into on air. Although my boy Heineken makes my Kong salad out there. But that's about it. But otherwise, I know numerous people who function out there, and I ain't ready yet. Levin Miller. When you say go back to Arawaki to go eat, we can talk about it. All right, let's take a break so we can get Jamal in here. All right, we're going to take a break, and we're going to be speaking with New Life for a while, and we can maybe help you with some of his stuff. I could have used him last week, boy. Anyway, take a break, and we'll be right back.
Tickets are selling fast.
It's a season of love concerts.
Performing live.
Gary
Harris,
Wayne Wonder,
and DeVille.
Saturday, December 3rd,
inside the Thomas Robinson National Stadium,
Nassau, Bahamas.
Tickets are available now
at all your Cash and Go locations,
or log on to cashandgobahamas.com.
Select the menu option,
and then select services,
and press tickets to be part of the biggest event of the year.
Or purchase your tickets by downloading the Cash and Go app,
or visit your local Cash and Go store
by selecting the locator option,
where you'll find a physical location near you.
It's the Season of Love Concert,
presented by
Excalibur Entertainment,
YBE Promotions,
and All Star Productions.
Sponsored by
Bahama Sands,
Chef Creole,
Masqueraders,
Cash and Gold.
Family Island discounted flights are available on Bahama Sands.
Saturday, December 3rd, inside the Thomas Robinson National Stadium,
Nassau.
Gates open at 8 p.m.
Be there.
I used to think of the bank as my personal ATM machine. If I wanted a new car, new furniture, a weekend trip to Miami, no problem. Just max out the credit card or top up my loan. I was a big baller until I realized that 75% of my salary was going to pay back all those loans. Fidelity's personal financial coaching was the best solution. Fidelity gave me a plan with a debt consolidation loan that has a built-in savings that pays 5% interest. I now only have one low monthly payment, plus money in my pocket. Give Fidelity Bank a call at 356-7764 in Nassau or 352-6676 in Freeport. Visit any of Fidelity's locations or visit a website at fidelitygroup.com.
At Ron's Electric Motors, they repair and rewind all major brands of electric motors, including water pumps, generators, and the generator's back end, welding machines, electric lifts, air compressors, battery chargers, and more. They're equipped to handle up to 850 kilowatts and rewind up to 450 horsepower motors. They're conveniently located on the corner of Wolf and Clarence Roads and are open weekdays 8 a.m. to 5 p.m., Saturdays till noon. They offer 24 hours emergency assistance. You can reach them at 242-356-0249.
If you were exposed to COVID-19, have symptoms, or traveled recently, get tested so that you can have peace of mind about your status. Just visit one of our convenient locations on New Providence at the University of the Bahamas or Golden Gates Plaza, weekdays 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. and Saturdays 10 a.m. to 6 p.m. On Eleuthera at the Three Island Dock, Mondays through Thursdays, 8 a.m. to 6 p.m., Fridays and Saturdays, 8 a.m. to 7 p.m., and Sundays, 8 a.m. to 3 p.m. On Exuma at the Regatta Park, weekdays, 9 a.m. to 3 p.m., Saturdays, 9 a.m. to 5 p.m., and Sundays, 1 p.m. to 6 p.m. On Abaco at Maxwell Food Store, Mondays through Saturdays, 8 a.m. to 5 p.m. The COVID-19 test results will be ready in 15 minutes, and the tests are free.
This message is brought to you by PAHO WHO and the Ministry of Health and Wellness.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to the Revolution here on Guardian Radio 96.9 FM. My name is Juan McCartney. Good to have you with us. All right, we got Jamal Monker from New Life Cell Food Vegetation here in the house. Usually I'm coming to him, but he's coming to me today. And he's got a brand new product. And we're also trying to figure out our own stuff. And before we get into this, I want to say that it is, you know, it's been a couple of years since we've had COVID and we've been doing all this mask wearing XYZ. And, you know, we were all very, you know, on edge about COVID, but then there's all this other stuff that's still out there. So, and I just, like, kids were getting this respiratory infection and I just got the flu. And, you know, I was telling you that I didn't feel like terribly sick with flu symptoms. And when the symptoms started clearing up, I just had like this fatigue hit me that I haven't felt in many years. And so you got to be careful out there too, and you got to strengthen your immune system. And the crazy part is I do take my vitamins every day. I take my CMOS and stuff, you know, and my cordyceps, and yet still even me, and I work out, you know what I mean? And I still got it. So you got to be careful out there, and you got to keep your immune system healthy. What do you do to just keep your immune system up and boosted?
I'm back. I'm pleasure to be back. I feel like I'm home. Yeah,
awesome. Absolutely.
Yeah, man. Juan is the best. I want to thank those that's been supporting us and you know whatnot. But immune system, immune health. Me as a naturopathic practitioner, what we do is we look at it holistically. We don't just say, drink this and call me in the morning, or drink this and drink that, or take that, or try this or try that. Mm-hmm. What we do is we look at your constitution. Each individual have a different constitution, meaning you may display certain symptoms, but how you got there. And what's perpetuating as a catalyst may be different from somebody else. Mm-hmm. For instance, somebody may have hypertension, and the person next to them may also have hypertension. One may be based on blockage, another one may be based on their girlfriend just leave them. So you see what I'm saying? So the one with blockage...
So your pressure go down in that case.
Yeah, yeah. You know, and some people have what we call white coat syndrome. As soon as they go in the doctor's office, the anxiety.
Right,
exactly. Yeah. So the immune system is similar. It responds to your way of life, your lifestyle. So in other words, if you're someone who exercise, you're gonna have a different type of immune response than somebody who's a couch potato. And if you are somebody that eat healthy, you're gonna have a more healthy response. The immune system is gonna be more efficient.
Right.
So when we ask the question, how can we boost or bolster the immune system? Then we have to ensure that we are ruling out things that's going to have a deleterious effect on that. For instance, if you are somebody who haven't done a detox in 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 years, then the good place to start would be the detox, because it's a tremendous strain on your immune system if the inside of your body is dirty.
Right.
So let's start there first.
Right.
And so these are different conversations. When we do consultation, we look at the individual from their constitution standpoint, their individual, and we look at them as a human being, not as a number, not a statistic. We look at them and we listen. We listen to what they say to us as a practitioner, and based on the conversation, then we will know what should we do and what we should not do.
Mm-hmm. Excellent.
Yeah. Yes.
All right. So you got to kind of just take a holistic approach to the whole thing. Usually start with the cleanse, because gut health is really important too.
Oh, most definitely. Yeah. And another thing is stress is a factor, because stress also impacts gut health. If I throw a force snake at you right now, you feel something literally spew in your gut. You'd be like, ah. Or you say, man, I have this gut feeling. Or I feel it in my gut.
Right.
You don't eat.
Right.
Because you stress. Man, stress affects your gut.
Mm-hmm.
It affects your digestive system. And if your body can't digest food, you end up with malnourishment.
Right.
So it all boils back to the gut. Mm-hmm. And I agree with you. We have to make sure that that's at optimum. And gut imbalance is prevalent in the Bahamas.
Okay. So we got a lot going on in society. I've talked to you several times. I talked to one of the doctors who came out when we were doing the remote at New Life. Talked about this, and Dr. Danny Johnson has come in here and talked about basically this is an epidemic.
Diabetes. Mellitus, yeah. Right, diabetes, yeah. Mellitus. And it's because, one, I think, you know, I'm going to go on a limb and say this, and probably get, you know, people going to not like it, but the truth hurts. And the thing about it is this, our culture, our tradition, our culture, we need to break it.
Mm-hmm.
Because some of these that we've, you know, taken on as our culture is recent.
Mm-hmm.
You know, for instance, let me give an example. I mean, you talk about this, and we laugh at this off air a few times, but let me reiterate this. You know, Good Friday, you're pre-diabetic.
Mm.
You get 12 buns made with white flour and white sugar, white oil, and you glaze the cross with white sugar, right? And when you can be pre-diabetic no more, just off that right there. Then, to make matters worse, we get some fish, and we dip the fish in more flour, and then we fry it in that black oil. Oftentimes reheated oil, trans fat, hydrogenated, partially hydrogenated, and polyunsaturated fatty acid. These oil aggregate. It's like looking in the back of the stove, and you see that oil, that goo.
Mm-hmm.
And this would cause triglycerides and cholesterols and heart disease.
That in your arteries, right there.
That's in the arteries right there.
Yeah, right.
So you're no longer pre-diabetic now because you're impeding the function of the pancreas, the liver. You know, and so we are hurting ourselves. So diabetes was declared in 2012 by the then Minister of Health at COB campus, Dr. Perry Gomez. It was declared an epidemic in the Bahamas.
Mm-hmm.
And guess what? It's self-inflicted through ignorance.
Right.
Not in a condescending way. Simply to say that we just don't know. We are hurting ourselves. Are we going to continue to do so? Or are we going to begin to stem the progression, to stop it dead in its track? But you can't do it if you're not inoculated with the information.
Mm-hmm.
And so it's my job now to be a small voice, a small drop in the ocean, to make some noise, to make some ripple as we begin the journey. And this glucose balance is just one of this 13 years research, by the way.
Yeah, so let's start. Let's dig in this. So there's a product called Glucose Balance.
Yes.
Taraxacum and bilberry.
Yes.
And
The taraxacum, by the way, it's amazing because it's been proven scientifically to, you know, because it has something called inulin, and that prevents sugar from spiking, essentially. So you're talking about a scientific research that has been, you know, decocted into this formula. And so you just need two tablespoons of that.
Mm-hmm. So this is all organic.
Yes.
All right. No chemicals or anything like this.
Yes.
This addresses diabetes type 2.
Yes.
All right. So type 2 is the kind that you get.
Yes. Yes. Right. Type 2. Type 1 is an autoimmune.
Right.
Which require insulin. And we deal with that as well. But it requires, all of them require consultation. But that more diligence and more carefulness, because you have to be responsible, because oftentimes diabetes affect people's kidneys.
Mm-hmm.
All these people you see on dialysis,
mm-hmm.
and with eye issues and with neuropathy and extremities issue with amputation,
right.
all of that is because they lean on their own understanding. A lot of them say, I'm going to change my diet. I'm no longer going to eat red meat,
mm-hmm.
but then I'm going to eat vegetables. And the vegetable that they select
mm-hmm.
would be things like cassava.
Okay.
And cassava have 99.9% starch.
Mm.
Cassava turns into sugar.
Mm.
Starch turns into sugar. So eating starch is like eating raw sugar.
Right.
So a lot of persons may say, I eat vegetables, but I eat cassava, I eat potato, I eat carrots and beets, and beets will beet you up.
Really?
They beet you to pieces. That's why it's called beets.
Wow.
It's loaded with sugar.
Wow.
Most of the sugar is made from beets, by the way.
I just thought beets were like good for blood pressure and all this.
Yeah, it may be so.
Right.
But it also...
It'll take
you. Yeah,
it'll
beet you. It's called beets. It'll beat you.
Okay. So diabetes type 2, jaundice. What's jaundice?
Yeah, jaundice is the liver. You know,
gotcha.
People's eye that turn yellow.
Okay.
Yeah,
right.
Like when you eat, people want to don't eat green fruits.
Right.
Yeah, jaundice, yeah.
Yeah.
Because it puts strains on the liver.
Mm. Gallbladder problems.
And that's happening a lot. Gallstones, and it's because of the bad water. You're not drinking enough water.
Mm.
And, you know, the greasy food and all that stuff.
Mm.
The body's not secreting enough bile because we are not eating enough bitters. Too much sugar. Remember, now it's have to be a balance. Sugar, sweet, sour, bitter, spicy, or pungent.
Mm-hmm.
All of them have different resonance that give the body different 102 minerals. So each one of them represents something. So if you eat too much of one,
mm-hmm.
too much sweet. Sweet is good because if a sugar drop too low, you got to eat a candy to bring it up. So you
right.
can't live without sugar. So sugar, but in portions and balance. Another thing I see people make mistake is they do fast, right? And they do juice fast. But what they do is they extract the juice from the fruit,
right?
And they relieve the pulp. They leave the fiber,
right? Yeah,
there's a
just
reason,
the sugar. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. So you eat literally, extracting a portion of the wholesome part of that plant,
mm-hmm.
and so now you're doing a juice fast, and that's putting strain on your kidneys and your liver.
Mm.
That's not a good thing.
Right.
So then some people do it for 2 weeks,
wow.
3 weeks. They do. That's very dangerous.
Wow. Okay. Fluid retention.
Yeah.
Now is this. Not to cut you off. Is mm. this to do with chronic congestive heart failure?
Congestive
sort of
heart, the kidneys.
Mm.
And then oftentimes, too, sluggish or, evacuation system that is not efficient.
Mm.
So if your waste system is building up, those microorganisms, it builds on the coarse fluid to become stagnant in the body. We're talking about bioaccumulation that has become morbid and rancid in the system. And it, there's evidence of that, and it is tension in the waist. You see people with distended waist?
I do see that.
Okay,
yeah.
So that's, well, my wife was pregnant for 9 months, and she said, boy, that was a lot of pain on her back. Mm-hmm. So I don't know how fellas could do it for 9 years. You know what I mean? So they need back brace. And I'm serious. I mean, like, some of the stomach, the distension I see is really huge.
Yeah.
You know?
Well, I'll say this. Anyway, we could talk more about it.
Yes.
But I'll say this. You got to, at some point, kind of take control of what's going on.
And that's fuel in the diabetes, right. By the way. That's fuel. That's the fuel. That's like you have a jet liner that is intercontinental. It could, you know, it can go long distance. So the diabetes can be around for a long time as long as that distension is there. People ask me, how to get rid of these diabetes, how to lose weight, how to do all it. Listen, once you do the detox, you eat more fiber, eat more wholesome food, you eat food in season.
Mm-hmm.
It's simple. It's not convoluted, you know. We've convoluted it with all these fads, with eat your blood type, the paleo diet, this diet, that diet, the next diet. I'd never seen a wild goat consult with a nutritionist.
Right.
He don't even wash his grass off.
Right.
When the rain beat the dirt and the dirt splash on the grass, he eat that. Why?
Right.
And that's good because it's strengthening his gut now, because now those B17 and B12 on that grass, it's fortifying the system. But with us, we are getting sick because we are eating sterilized food that's been imported.
Right.
And I always say, me and you always crack joke with this, if it's imported, it's not important.
Right.
And so we see a lot of time that the food that we import, that we eat, that is bring in for us, you know, it's sterilized.
Yep.
They wash it off too much.
But pesticides on it.
Yeah, we score on the dirt, but that dirt that we scorn, we can't live without it because that's what grow our crops.
Right.
And it's not, we call it dirty, but that loaded with some powerful stuff.
Yeah, nutrients.
Some people even eat clay.
Really?
You know what I'm saying? The bentonite clay and the red desert clay, those were powerful clays.
Wow. Okay. Blood cancer.
Yes.
That's leukemia.
Yes. It's been shown to affect that because what it does is remove the inflammation. Mm-hmm. Out of the blood, and it stops a process called glycation and oxidation. And all of these, by the way, diabetes is also linked to aging. If you want to prevent aging or slow down the aging process, what we call anti-aging,
mm-hmm.
it serves you right to get your diabetes reversed.
Mm-hmm.
And diabetes can be reversed, contrary to popular belief.
Yeah.
Because we remember now, you was healthy, then you became pre-diabetic, and then you became a full-fledged. So it was something pushing you. That's behind your back, that's pushing you from being healthy to pre to now, okay, I have this, 5, 10, 15, 20 million people around the world have it, so I'm normal, right. I have a booklet, I can manage it, and so it is what it is.
Right.
And then you're going to go blind, sex life going to mess up, that comes with the territory. And right. So we accept that hook, line, and sinker. But yeah. I'm here today to tell you that don't have to be so. You can reverse that, but it's going to take discipline, patience, faithfulness, endurance, and stickability.
Right.
You can do it.
Now, it also provides vitamin A, C, and D.
Yes.
All right. What's A and D for?
Well, they are powerful antioxidants. And of course, you know, you get the vitamin D from the sun.
Mm-hmm.
These vitamins, they are what we call scavengers of free radical.
Mm-hmm.
They scavenge free radical. And by the way, free radical is found wherever disease is. And free radical, by the this may sound insane, but free radical do have positive job description in the body. It is necessary. It is part of the oxidation. When you breathe oxygen, free radical comes with it, and it helps to do stuff. But the problem is when it proliferate out of control. Just like you have something called homocysteine, and homocysteine occurs with methylation. And methylation is a natural process that keeps cells in the body healthy.
Mm.
And when free radicals is left unattended and it proliferate, it causes homocysteine to get out of control. And this causes heart disease, it causes cancer, it causes dementia, it causes liver issues. It's all because we allow this balance. This cycle is a natural cycle between methionine and homocysteine. When this balance is off, that's what causes it. You can't live without the methylation process, the oxidation process, and the glycation process. But the problem is trying to balance those processes. Once you could bring balance, and that's how the body operates. It operates like a car. You know, if that car, timing belt pops, and you put the belt back on, but you don't time it properly,
you're going to reset it.
You're going to have issue. So it's all about God time our body.
Right.
And he gave us the manual.
Right.
And he said, this is what you should do.
Right.
But it's other things like external factors like stress that that potentially can throw this equilibrium.
So the stress is a big part of it.
Stress. And that's why, like with this product now, mm-hmm. it also has something called nerving and calmative properties, meaning it calms the body down.
Mm-hmm.
It calms the nerve so that you can cope with stressful situation.
Right.
A lot of people, when your body is acidic mm-hmm. and your body is under duress, it's very hard for you to cope with stress, and you short a patient, you have a short fuse,
right?
Because you're sick.
I think stress is killing people around here.
Oh, you think?
And causing a lot of these like sickness, and you know what I mean?
Because
people know if you don't cut it off, if you don't manage your own stress, ain't nobody else can manage it for you.
Listen, it's really we have to, like, certain countries, you know, they incorporate like Tai Chi and yoga mm-hmm. and their aromatherapy and hydrotherapy. People don't understand the significance of having some type of form of spirituality to mm-hmm. calm, some type of that's to de-stress, to what we call as an outlet,
mm-hmm.
just to hit the off button, the mm-hmm. reset button,
right,
and just to just say, you know what, let me come off the grid, and just allow that body. Some people don't sleep,
right.
Some literally, you have a lot of behemoths who can't sleep,
right,
and if they do sleep, they get an hour sleep. And guess what? If you go in the gym and you work out and you don't sleep, you ain't gonna build muscle.
Yeah, it ain't gonna work, yeah.
Sleeping is just as important as lifting weights.
Absolutely.
It's just as important as eating healthy.
Right.
It's just as important as managing stress. You don't sleep.
Correct. Ain't another.
Yeah. So I ain't talking about laying down now. Laying down is different from sleep. I'm talking about REM sleep, that right. deep REM sleep. That's different because
go to sleep, right.
The cells recharge, it reanimates, it regenerates, it proliferates, and it causes the immune system. You talking about the immune?
Mm-hmm.
There's nothing better for the immune system than sleep.
Right, yeah. That's what you need.
Yes.
All right. Magnesium, iron, and potassium are also...
Yes, and you know magnesium has to do with nerve. It has to do with stress. Mm-hmm. It has to do with the muscle. It has to do with sleep as well. And a lot of us lack in magnesium.
Right.
And stress, by the way, strips away all of those you just mentioned, all those minerals. Mm-hmm. Stress teeth them away with the body.
It takes it out of you.
Yes.
What is potassium doing?
Well, the potassium, is you can find that in the sea moss, but it's also in that. It helps to bring balance. And a lot of time, persons take these laxative and then remove potassium with the system, right? And potassium is important, you know, with water balance in the body too. These with the kidney, the urinary system.
Mm.
It is very important for that and for circulation. So, you know, the sea moss along with that, but that within itself, as a natural diuretic. So persons that have, we talk about this edema, this fluid that build up in extremities, even persons that have elephantitis, we've seen, you know, we give them the sea moss, you know, potassium, natural potassium. We've seen they urinate the fluid right out of their legs and the elephantitis goes down.
Goes down.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah. And the heart, of course, you know, the fluid. And then tinnitus. You see people with this ringing in their ears and stuff like that. That's because of fluid as well.
Really?
Fluid, yes, fluid. And it causes imbalance. All that is linked. It's linked to the gut, like you say.
Wow. Okay, blood clots. That's a problem.
That's a big problem. Thrombosis. And oftentimes they give you blood thinners and they tell you stop the vitamin K and stuff like that. And we know for a fact that this helps to regulate and improve viscosity in the blood, the natural viscosity. And so it dissolves blood clot, which is very dangerous because it can become large in different parts of the body.
Mm-hmm.
So it's a very safe, well-researched Tarazakum. Okay. Very safe product and zero side effect.
And also eye health, this addresses.
Because, you know, diabetes, it affects the eyes.
Makes you go blind, yeah.
Yeah, so a lot of specialists make money from diabetes.
Mm-hmm.
It impacts so much part of the body.
Right.
You know, the eye specialist is overwhelmed, the kidney specialist... Right.
Well, that's what I was telling you about Dr. Danny Johnson was here, and he was like, he doesn't have enough people to perform enough of the surgeries where people are too far gone with their feet. But he was like, he wants to
gangrene
move beyond that to try to restore people's feet in terms of just the amputations, because it's like way up.
Prevention is better than cure, and diabetes is oftentimes is worse than cancer because it affects so much different parts of the body in so much different ways, and everybody is affected differently.
Right.
And it affects, like I say, stress, because you could imagine when the first symptoms of diabetes is weight loss, you're a big healthy person. All of a sudden,
right.
you lost 15, 20 pounds. muscle atrophy. And people say, boy, look, you have AIDS. And, you know, but it affects so much, it's so fast. And right. It fluctuates, so you have these swings in your weight.
Mm-hmm.
You feel lethargic, you don't feel like a man. You feel half of a man
right.
or half yeah. of a woman. And it affects your whole psyche, it puts you in a state of stupor.
Yeah.
And that's why a product like the glycol is so important, because, like I said, 2 ounces of that. We had a lady, her sugar was 200, and immediately after she tested, it dropped down to like 119.
Wow.
And that's what I'm saying. 200? 200, yeah. Oof. And yesterday it was 81 when she checked it.
Wow.
And with this without her medication. Remember now,
how long was she taking this?
About 2 weeks now.
Really?
Yeah. And then, you know, she had issues where 500. She got 500.
What?
Yeah.
500?
Yeah. And she taking meds.
Wow.
You know?
All right. So glucose, balance, taraxacum, and bilberry.
And bilberry was given to World War II pilots for night vision. They ate the bilberry jam, and they was able to see in the night.
Really?
And now bilberry is used as an eye. It's known scientifically for eye health.
I need some of that.
Yeah, bilberry. Right. We had a doctor who, she told me she was able to drive in the night again.
Really?
Yeah, because of the bilberry.
Yeah, I can't drive at night. Like I was driving from Lyford Key on Saturday. You know, my wife's aunt had a thing, and I had to wear my glasses. I had to put on my brights and all this. Like,
wow.
Because you know, I had no lights on.
Yeah.
Just a little, you know, things in the ground.
You need 30, man. We gotta fix that. We gotta fix that, man.
I do. My eyesight has gotten progressed. Yeah. It used to be perfect, and then so they had 40 to turn it to trash. Yeah. Okay, so where can we get Gluco? We can get it at
New Life, Old Fort Bay or E Street.
Old Fort Bay or E Street.
Yeah.
You know, I want to talk about Old Fort Bay because I saw you guys were doing some stuff out there.
Yes.
Now, we talk about the food and we talk about eating and healthy lifestyle. People just don't have the first clue.
Yes.
So I found that also I've been reading up on this, and this is going to sound silly because I'm new to all this, but I find that gluten has a lot to do with a lot of people's like weight gain.
That's right.
The gluten allergy. People don't know that they're allergic to gluten or shouldn't be eating as much gluten, but everything, you talk about flour, pastry, everything, gluten, bread,
and dairy,
right,
and you know, even those vegans who or those healthy persons, their portions are wrong.
Mm-hmm.
It's just too much carbs, not enough protein, and not enough greens or grains, and the food content should be also like 20%. Your veggie should be 50%. Your protein should be 25%. And your grain should be a measly 5%.
Right.
But in the Bahamas, we have rice take up all the plate. That's 50%.
Right.
So we tell people to try to balance their plate. Because if you even a vegan and you eating too much pasta, then you know you'd be in some deep water with diabetes.
Really?
Because it's just too much starch, too much carbs.
Yeah, it's too much going on.
Yeah,
body, some people like just that.
Yeah, the body needs. Yeah. See, in people's mind, we feel like if we don't eat a lot, you're going to lose weight.
Mm-hmm.
But it's not about quantity. It's about quality. It's not about the amount of what you put in your mouth.
Right.
It's about the substance and the nutritional content that you put into your mouth. So in other words, you can put a palm full of food, and that'll do better than a big plate of food.
Right.
Because your fist is the size of your stomach when you boil your fist.
Right.
And so this whole notion that you have to eat like a big plate.
Right.
That the body can receive all that anyway.
Right.
You know, it only takes what it needs at that time and the rest is cast aside.
Right,
so
it
makes sense to eat food that is going to nourish your body on a cellular level.
Mm-hmm.
You give the body what is required, not what you want or what you feel like eating. No, you give the body what it needs and it will reward you. And we see people with diabetes, they're being rewarded.
Yeah.
They're being rewarded with that, but they're being rewarded for what they put in.
Right.
And when you put the wrong thing in, then diabetes becomes inevitable. Heart disease becomes inevitable. Because of ignorance, we perish for lack of knowledge.
Right.
And we see it every day.
So what kind of, so tell us about the menu at Old Fort Bay. And you got more like the sit-down style at Old Fort
Bay. Oh, yeah. We have a nice, restaurant. You could bring your family down there.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of people still don't know that New Life of a Star in Old Fort Bay.
Right.
Right in the plaza. You know, the Fresh Market Plaza, right in that plaza right there.
Right.
We are right there. We've been there from 2020. You can get smoothies.
I like those.
Yeah, we have the Chapanillo smoothie.
Right.
We have the berry smoothies. We have the green smoothies. We have the sea moss shake.
Mm-hmm.
And so we have protein shake as well, that you protein smoothies. And we have other ones we can deviate and create other new exciting stuff. And then we have the wild rice. We have the quinoa. You have the mushroom burger, which is a popular one. You can get that with the squash.
I've had the mushroom burger.
Yeah.
It's outstanding.
Exactly. Yeah. And we have the quinoa burger, the chickpea burger. Then we have two soups every day.
Okay.
Today, we have chickpea soup and okra soup. And you don't miss the salt pork, the salt beef.
No?
Yeah, no.
Yeah, I know. Y'all do some magic.
Yeah.
I know. That's Kermit.
Yeah.
When we said New Life last time, that's Kermit. Yeah, me and Kermit's eating like kings.
Yeah, man. So,
I hook you up, Ali.
And you and Mr. Meat, like, you literally have the struggle to eat a whole burger.
Right.
I'm telling you, you don't miss the meat, and it's flavorful. It's not bland at all.
Yeah.
It's really delicious.
And you guys make your own bread.
We make our own sauce, right. Our own bread. Everything's made in-house.
Yeah, it's excellent. Yeah. It doesn't have all that gluten and all that.
And like I said, you could bring your family down. You can dine outside. You know, we have the Simon salad that tastes like Kong salad.
Mm.
You had it before?
I haven't had the Simon salad.
You never had that before?
No, I never had a Simon salad.
Okay, yeah. So that's... And by the way, next month, we're going to be in Elutra.
Okay.
We're going to be taking the food down and samples. And so those of you listening to me that's in Eleuther, get ready because New Life is coming there. And we ain't coming to play.
Whole shebang?
Yeah, the whole shebang. You know how we do. We don't half step. We ain't coming to shoot marbles. So we're putting diabetes, cancer on notice. We actually partnering with the Cancer Society up there. We're going to be in Harbor Island. We're going to be in North Eleuther. And we're going to be in Governor's Harbor. So it's going to be an Eleuther affair. And then we also have Mangrove Key in our crosshair.
Okay.
We plan on doing something in Mangrove Key as well. And so we are going to be doing some island hopping, different island. And, of course, we can't forget. Anyway, let me don't put that out there.
Oh, you got something else going on.
Yeah, we got some stuff, some good stuff happening.
Me now what product you're talking about. Let me take a picture of it.
Yes. It's a new product. It just came out.
All right. It says, good day. I'm mid-40s, male, occasional drinker, not a heavy eater, avid walker. My stomach still looks 5 months pregnant. What's going on based on this little description?
What's that?
It says I'm a mid-40s male, occasional drinker, not a heavy eater, avid walker, but my stomach still looks like 5 months pregnant. What's going on based on this little description?
Yeah, well, he need to, if he's in the mid-40s and he's just walking, as a man that is 40... walking will not suffice because you lose, you're not aerobic now where you're losing testosterone.
You need to do some weight training.
You need weight. You need resistance.
Resistance training.
Yeah. You need some resistance and that will help that along with a detox because you could be 100 years old and if you're in detox, that stomach ain't going nowhere.
Right.
And so that tells me that you need more, incorporate more fiber in your diet. You need to do a detox and you need to come see me so we can sit down and put together a plan for you. If you're serious, if you really, see the decision you make today will determine how you look, the quality of your life 10 years from now. You see, Juan made a conscious decision about 10 years ago or 8 years ago when I came here. He and I took a photo. And I look at that photo and he's ripped and shredded, right? But a year or so before that photo, he was obese. But he made a decision. Listen, I'm married, I have long children. Listen, this ain't me. No. I ain't going out like this.
No, you
he
got
made
to.
And look at him. I must congratulate you. You're sticking with it, man.
I had to redo my life insurance, you know? And when I refilled out the form, my cousin, who's my agent, he came back to me. I was like, no, you got to come back in. Mm. I was like, what happened? He was like, you lost 100 pounds since you first did the life insurance. He's like, they want to make sure you're not like on drugs
or terminally
ill or something like that.
Wow, that's abnormal.
I had to go, right, yeah.
But you said, no, you know what? It's like the drug addict. Who wake up and say, no, this ain't me.
Yeah, I'm tired of it.
I'm tired of it. Yeah,
absolutely.
Yeah, you have to become tired of it. Right. And you know, you if you have a wife, right, a beautiful wife, like you do.
Yeah.
And if you don't take care of yourself.
Right. Someone else be.
Yeah, you
have take to, care of your wife.
Yeah, you have to take care of yourself. And then you have to show people that I care about myself.
Mm-hmm.
Because if they say, boy, Juan really care about himself, then their approach to you is going to be cautious because they'd be like, boy, he's taking care of himself.
Right.
He's well dressed. He's well groomed. He's well learned. And so I can't come half stepping.
Right.
But if you have coal in your eye, your breath stink, and you know you just look like somebody hawk and spit you out, then people will approach you like that.
Right. Yeah. Then I got to take you seriously.
Yeah. What I'm saying. But if you are someone that is every aspect of your life, you know, and I want to. I want to challenge my fellow Bohemian that's tuning into me. I challenge you that I don't care what your circumstances is. If you are 600 pounds or you are underweight, But if you're not satisfied with your health, don't just lay down and expect somebody to make you healthy. I want you to understand that you got there because of you. And so you can move you from there. You remember that lady who said, boy, I have a wedding 3 months from now. I got to go to the gym to fit in this dress.
Right.
Or the doctor saying to you, you're pregnant, so you can't eat X, Y, Z. So why you only want to do it when you fit in a wedding gown? Why you only want to do it when the doctor say you're pregnant?
Right.
That means you should never eat those things in the first place.
Correct.
So not just when you want to fit in a wedding gown, you want to take care of your health.
Right.
So we need to look at, put things in perspective.
And it's for men, men, you got to take care of yourself. We have a shorter life expectancy than women. You know, you take on all this stress, you don't take care of yourself. Women go to the doctor more regularly. Men often wait until something's wrong.
That's right.
You know, and then they start going, well, I should do something. But you got to take care of yourself if you're going to want to make it for the long haul, you know?
And you know, traditionally, I was born and raised in Cat Island. And I'm not speaking conjecture or hearsay. I'm talking about seeing the black, strong, strapped men in the community. Those men had broad shoulders, bad ears, broad nose, and big feet. And they were strong. And it was easy for them to live 80, 90 years old.
Right.
That was a piece of cake for them. Why? Because their lifestyle dictates that. What we go to the gym and we call boot camp, that was functional training for them, because when they cast their net, and they pull that in. They work that back row.
It was working, right? Yeah.
When they work 3 acres with the pickaxe, they work in shoulders and traps. And
right.
Lats. Mm. So when you see them bare back at 80,
they're big strapping dudes. Yeah. Right? Yeah.
And absolutely. They could climb. They climb the coconut tree, man.
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah. The Cat Island. Yeah. Now be careful of that. Now that's baby maker.
All right. This says. Let's do a couple. We got to go to break. We'll be back. This says, hi Juan. Glad you're feeling better. If new life comes, can you ask him about the eye wash? How often to use, and if it has to be put in the fridge? What are the benefits for your eyes?
Yeah, the eye wash pulls mucus out of your eyes. Let me see. I'm gonna pause my stream because I want people to hear this. Well, if you're on Facebook, I'll be back on. I time limited anyway, so. But I want to hear this because this is a U.S. Customs officer, man. He went through customs. One of my clients from, I think, Ohio. Mm-hmm. He had a bunch of healing tonic and Kerala tonic, and he's going through customs.
Right.
And the U.S. Customs officer said, what you have here? And when he saw the New Life Day, but he said, you went to Jamal? Oh, man, I took the eye wash. And the eye wash worked wonders for me, man. And he's like, man, but I thought you was going to stop me. He said, stop you? No, man, you did the right thing. So the eye wash pulls mucus of the eyes. It's something that is excellent. So let me see. You can hear this clip here.
Mm-hmm.
Like your pressure went from with the New Life stuff?
My pressure was for years been 19, 20 at the eye doctor. I went to New Life, took the eye wash, and went down to 12. Verified, got 2 eye doctors, 12, baby. The eye wash, I pull all the mucus out. Try it. It works.
You are custom.
Okay. Man, okay. So he went from 20 to 12.
It's the pressure in the eyes. Eye. Yeah, and he went to 2. So he had two he went to 2 eye specialists, and they were not able to
bring his pressure down. He came to New Life.
When he was in Freeport or something, you know, being worked at U.S. Customs, he was not concerned.
Yeah, I noticed, like, Dave, hearing about you in America now.
Oh, well, we've been shipping a long time.
Right.
Not just U.S. or U.K. Mm. We ship all around the world.
Right.
Japan, all over.
Yeah.
All over we ship. And it's because, you know, Dr. Sebi, I don't think you're going to find any person out there other than me that Dr. Sebi endorsed.
Mm-hmm.
Like, literally said, you know,
right,
go to Jamal.
Right.
Or Jamal, give me CMOS.
Right.
The first time I taste CMOS, Jamal, just in that. So really? I don't think you're gonna see that. And because of that, we have people like, you know, Sidney Rice, the NFL player.
Mm-hmm.
We have Meek Mill.
Right.
You know, who take our products. We have Boju Banton, Tyrus Riley. We have a lot of different people that, different celebrities.
Mm-hmm.
We have movie stars that, you know, that comes, they take the product. And you know what's so amazing? We don't go solicit to them.
Right. People tell them.
No, they'll say, well, listen, I took your product, man. I've been struggling for years. And this is the only thing that worked for me. I need to talk to you.
Mm-hmm.
Wow. They'll link me. They'll seek me out. And they'll be like, man, I try. And that's why I say people don't know what they have here in New Life. They don't understand. People don't understand. Listen, these tonics, like the healing tonic, comes from Central America. We have people in the mountain that works for New Life, that lives in the mountain, that all day they gather herbs and ship it to us. Like the Kalawala.
Mm-hmm.
The Kalawala is indigenous to Honduras.
Wow.
It only grows there, nowhere else in the mountains. And we have people that lives in the mountains that ship these herbs. So we don't go to a store and buy herbs. It right. comes straight from the forest.
Mm-hmm.
And that is why it's so potent. That is why it's so beneficial. And it's getting these powerful results. Diabetes, people say, literally, I have literally a gentleman from Abaco. We don't have time, but when I come back, I'll let you. I played now nationally. This gentleman was struggling with, he lost 60 pounds. He lost, he no longer have cholesterol. He no longer have hypertension. And when they check his blood, there's no trace of diabetes.
Wow.
I'm talking about someone that was struggling for 8 years with diabetes. 8 years plus years.
Yeah.
There's no trace.
Wow.
In other words, it's been cured, reversed.
I wanted to ask you about cholesterol.
Yeah.
We got a minute.
Yes.
I've been told a way to lower cholesterol is to take whey.
Whey protein?
Yeah, whey protein.
No. Niacin is probably more efficient.
Niacin.
Yeah, but there's something called L-carnosine.
I know L-carnitine, yeah.
Not carnitine.
Carnosine.
People get a mix up.
L-carnosine.
Yeah, and you take it with CoQ10 and vitamin E.
Okay, all right. Okay.
Yeah.
CoQ10. Now, niacin makes you feel like flush.
Yeah.
But it's still good to take.
Yeah, but what I'm saying is, alternatively, you can try getting certain foods, but the B3, the right. B vitamins, try eat foods with leafy greens, dark leafy greens, that
okay.
will give you all of those. And that's why we promote dark leafy greens and vegetables, because as 50% of your plate, because you're going to get all of those powerful antioxidants.
Mm-hmm.
You're talking about flavonoids, the carotenoids and the bioflavonoids. Those are very powerful. You have beta carotene, which is a powerful antioxidant, vitamin E that naturally comes, vitamin C. All of these are powerful antioxidants. And I keep saying antioxidant because antioxidants kills free radical, and free radical is found wherever there's disease.
Mm.
Free radical is in the eye. When you see someone with eye issue, free radical.
Wow.
Cancer, free radical. Diabetes, free radicals. Aging, free radical cause leaky gut syndrome.
Wow.
And leaky gut syndrome is the number one cause of the aging process. You see someone that look young? That's somebody who have a strong gut flora, and they have efficiently found a way to stem back, push back the aging process. I mean, even persons with a genetic predisposition for certain disease, once your gut system is intact, you can literally prevent that trigger from being pulled to trigger off that cancer, mm-hmm. to trigger off that disease.
We got to get out of here, but I'll do that really quickly. This person says, had knee surgery on Saturday and haven't had a bowel movement since. Highly unusual. What can I take?
Oh, no, bowel movement since knee surgery?
Since knee surgery.
That's fine. Like, a lot of stress and
right,
pain
yeah.
and stuff like that. Yeah.
Collation,
man.
Yeah.
Collation.
Yeah,
one word. Come on. See, and that's how you know you have a good product,
right,
man.
Gonna...
I don't even have to say. I don't
no,
have to
no,
say.
No. If you have any issues, come collation. Just a couple of this.
And he's serious. He's been trying to sell a product, ladies. Trust
no,
me.
No. Straighten you right up.
You know, Juan, don't play.
All right. So you can pick up Gluco at the East Street South store or the Old Ford base.
You got to come back, man. One hour's Robert.
No, yeah, you know, we learning new things. You're teaching us.
Yeah,
you know what
yeah,
I mean?
Yeah.
How to live better.
Yeah.
Because
yeah.
really, you find you get up in age
yeah.
and you start feeling like
yeah.
crap. And
yeah.
a lot of it's
yeah.
you're eating wrong and you're not putting the proper
yeah.
minerals in your body.
Yeah.
But thanks, Jamal,
I'll be back.
For coming through.
In the words of Arnold Schwarzenegger, I'll be back.
And do go check out lunch at Old Ford Bay. It's delicious. All right. We got to get out of here. We'll be back tomorrow, Lord willing. You guys take care out there. And have a great day, Bahamas.